Now, in a bid to test preparedness for the COVID vaccine rollout, all states and union territories will conduct a dry run today in at least 3 session sites. 25 healthcare workers will be identified by the medical officer in charge at each of these sites. While strict guidelines will be followed in terms of adherence to COVID norms, the designated centres have been mandated to have a cold chain for storage and administration of vaccines. Significant to note here is that some of the states have included districts that are situated in difficult terrain for the dry run. I'm joined by my colleague Srija, who's joining us this morning from Bengaluru. Srija, so Karnataka is in fact conducting the dry run in several locations, including in Bengaluru urban. Has the dry run activity started at the center that you're standing at?
Well, before the actual rollout begins, remember, we are looking at a dry run as far as Karnataka on the whole is concerned. Nearly 5 districts have been selected for this. And in these 5 districts, nearly 3 vaccination session sites have been selected. As far as Bengaluru is concerned, the place where I am standing here is the Kamakshi Palya, the primary health center. And of course, this is the entry, what we understand. Nearly 25 of the beneficiaries have been selected for this particular dry run. Remember, there is one. There are separate rooms. One is called the vaccination room, where exactly we are entering. Remember, the entire dry run will be carried out for at least about 2 hours. This is according to Gaurav Gupta, who is the administrator for the civic body Brihat Bengaluru Mahanagarapalike. And it is not just this particular session site as far as the dry run is concerned. There are 2 other locations also, which right now where we are reporting from is the West Zone. And we are also looking at South Zone, Vidyapeetha and Arnakal also. So these are 3 most important places where we are going to look at throughout the day from 9 a.m. when it is going to start till about 5 p.m. So clearly at each sites, we are going to see at least about 25 of them where they will undergo this entire dry run. Now, the most important thing for us to understand over here, once the entire vaccination room, once the entire dry run begins, there is another room what we are looking at. There is observation room, there is waiting room. And remember, the reports will then be sent to center for the center to analyze before the actual rollout begins. Now, remember, as far as Karnataka, the primary objective that we are looking at is to understand the operational feasibility before the full throttle vaccination begins here in the state of Karnataka. And of course, we are hearing from the BBMP administrators, officials, what they tell us is that even before the actual rollout begins, what they're clearly looking at this point in time is that, remember, as promised from the center, they are still awaiting as far as the ILRs are concerned or deep freezers are concerned. So these are the certain things that are to be looked at as far as before the actual rollout begins. But for today, what we see here is that just in Bengaluru, nearly 3 locations have been selected for the dry run. Once all that is completed, the entire report will be then sent to the center for assessing the situation, how well prepared the Bengaluru centers are.
Right. Srija, thank you so much for joining us with that. Stay with us. I'm also joined by my colleague Mugilan from Chennai. Chennai also is seeing dry run activity today. And take us through the kind of preparations that the Tamil Nadu government has in fact made for the dry run exercise.
Definitely, we are in one such center. We are at Rajiv Gandhi Government Hospital, where the dry run will be taking place today here in Tamil Nadu. The dry run is happening across 5 districts and in 17 centers. And we are in one such center, Rajiv Gandhi Hospital. And you can see to my right where a first batch of frontline workers have been made to sit. So these are the frontline workers who will be first made to go through the dry run, and I will be explaining the procedure what everyone has to go through to during this dry run. So this is the inquiry table first, where if a frontline worker or anyone who comes first, they have to confirm their name, whether their name is in the list of the first batch. Then they will be entering inside the inside the vaccination center, where they have to digitally verify their name and the authentication number that has been given to him. So this is the registration desk, where first they have to see whether their name is in the list. Then they will be provided by an authentication number, and they should authenticate their number and name here at the registration center. Once they are approved, once they are authenticated, then they will be made to sit in the waiting room that has been set up here. You can see here waiting room where they will be made to sit. If there is a crowd or someone is getting vaccinated before them, then after waiting here, once they have been called, they will be taken to the place where the actual vaccination will happen. And you can see there are several booths that has been prepared here. Here only the vaccination will actually happen. And you can see this is the vaccination room where the person who comes here will be first. The vaccination will be administered. And you can see the medical professionals are already here. An arrangement has been made. This being a mock setup, so we have all these arrangements are already made. Once the person comes here, he will be made to sit here. And after all the initial checkups and observations, he will be administered with the vaccine. Then once he will not be sent out, or he will be sent to home. Then he will be sent to an observation room where he have to wait at least for half an hour, because the doctors will be again carrying out several observations on him. They will be having medical examinations on that person, and only after that, only after doctors or the medical professionals here feel he is deemed fit to leave the center, he will be allowed to leave the place. So this is the observation center which I was telling you about. So here only they will be made to sit. So here the doctors will test the basic parameters. They will be observing him. So once the observation is over, then they will be allowed to leave this place.
Right, Mugilan, thank you so much. Actually, a very comprehensive explanation of what exactly is going to be done at the vaccine drive center where you're standing at in Chennai. And elaborate arrangements have been made. Srija and Mugilan, please stay with us as we continue in our coverage of the vaccine drive and the rollout plan by states. Now, after the vaccine drive dry run, which is, of course, going to be conducted through the whole day today in states across the country, the center has also got mega plans for the vaccination drive, with many states actually issuing orders on preparations made to vaccinate people in respective states. Now, some states have also started collecting data about the vaccine candidates, and their details are being uploaded online as per the priority for vaccination. Of course, they will also be figuring out the priority groups who are going to get the vaccine first once that's cleared finally by the government. I'm joined by my colleague Mayuresh on this, who is joining us from the Kanjurmarg area here in Mumbai. Mayuresh, you're coming to us from a location where there's going to be a cold storage facility that the Maharashtra government is going to set up. And as we know that, like several other states, there are elaborate arrangements being made in order to make sure that all the facilities are ready prior to the vaccine drive actually starting.
Absolutely, Tanima. And if you see that this is the particular building of BMC-owned building, we have been given to understand on 1st, 3rd and on 4th floor, BMC has planned to create this kind of a cold storage. We have been also given to understand that the infrastructure, the basic infrastructure has been provided by the BMC, but BMC is waiting for center government to provide them the machinery which basically will be installed in these in this particular building. When we had word with the additional commissioner of BMC, with Suresh Kakani last night, he clearly told us that once this facility comes into play, or once this facility gets everything, then Mumbai's capacity or the BMC's capacity will be to store 50 lakh vials. So right now there are four such medical colleges which BMC has zeroed down, where they can save up to 5 to 7 lakh vials. But once this facility gets ready, and once this facility basically gets all the machinery which requires to store that particular culture or vials of vaccine, then it will be 50 lakh vials that Mumbai can store at one moment. Also, BMC BMC has chalked out the plan from where the vehicles will be coming from, what time the vehicles will be coming to carry out this particular vaccine, because transportation is one of the important aspects. And if required, BMC will also speak with the Mumbai police and the traffic police to provide them a green corridor. But that is if required. But their plan is almost ready. They have gone through their blueprint, which they have created 2 months back. And according to BMC, only 24 hours notice is enough for them to get everything ready and start the rollout of this particular vaccine.
Right. So, Mayuresh, what we can in fact see is that several arrangements have in fact been made for the vaccine rollout plan as well. And that is also something that we can see that several states have done, but also on the ground, we'll have to see what are the problems that they face. And that is also something which is most likely going to be thrown up in the vaccine drive dry run, which has in fact, which is being conducted today.